Hi, Alex here from Rebeloper.com and welcome back to the channel and welcome back to this exciting tutorial series on how you can have SwiftUI inside your UIKit apps. Yes, that is correct. Not the other way around like UIKit elements in a SwiftUI app, but SwiftUI elements in UIKit apps with the help of DuckUI. So without further ado, let's jump right into today's episode. Okay, and today we are going to talk about dividers and spacers. Now, if you have been tinkering with SwiftUI, you will see that there are some new elements and they are called dividers and spacers. And in DuckUI, there is something called like those. Okay, so what are basically spacers and dividers? When you want to lay out your UI, you want to have those white spaces, you want to have those gaps, basically dividers and spacers. You want to have some space to breathe. Okay, so I know that we have covered this in the previous videos, but today we are going to dive deeper into dividers and spacers. So this is where we left off. If you don't know what I'm talking about, go ahead and take a look at the previous videos. And I'm just going to simply quickly commit this. So this is the previous one, frame, width, and height. So we were talking about frames, widths, and height, and how you can set them in your basically stacks, because that's how you should lay out your views with DuckUI. And of course, with SwiftUI, they are highly recommended stacks. Okay, but today we are going to talk about dividers. And as you can see, I already have a divider here, but let's just take a look at it. So let's add a debug on there. And let me just add a debug on the second label too, so we can a little bit talk further where those views are and how they are laid out. And you should use debug in your code when you are laying everything out. Okay, so first of all, here you can see that I have a vertical stack with a spacing of 10, and these white spaces are the spacings, so that's okay. This top view, so-called, because it is indeed a UI view, is our vertical divider, okay? So it is set to normal, okay? And we will talk about spacer in just a moment. So what are these? Basically, these can be of more types. You could use a divider, simple, and add a perfect, like a pixel perfect size to it, and I will just do that in just a moment. But for now, let's just use these predefined types, like extra large, extra small, large, medium, normal, and small. You already saw the normal, so let's take a look at the extra small maybe, and maybe at the extra large. So yeah, you could just play around with it and get the feel of it. Yeah, that is that. And another thing that you should be aware of, that this divider is a vertical divider. So we are going to use it only in a vertical stack. So let's add another divider in this horizontal stack. So it is pretty simple to add. Let's just type in divider dot and just start typing in horizontal. And let's make this extra large, why not? And let's add a debug on that too. So debug, there we go. It should compile. Oh, we need to initialize the divider. There we go. So let's hit command R, or just hit the play button, and let's run our project. And there we go. I don't know if you kind of see the, but it should be really relatively simple to see that here is our extra large divider, because here we have our spacing for 20, and here we have our simple view, and here we have our hello DuckUI, and between those is a spacer. We are going to talk about in just a moment about spacers. Okay, so that is a horizontal divider. Okay, now maybe you don't like these extra large ones, or basically they are predefined, and you can take a look at the code to see basically how many pixels are there. But if you want to fine-tune your dividers, that is pretty simple. You just set, in our case of a horizontal stack, you just set the width. So set width, and let's see, I don't know, maybe 23. I believe that is not inside the standard divider types. And yeah, that will just print out 23 of width. Okay, there we go, it is 23. And the same goes for the vertical. You just set, not the width, the height of the divider. And basically that is all for dividers. So let's move on to spacers now. With spacers, those are just empty UI views. And as the name suggests, it is filling out the remaining space. Now, one thing to know is that the distribution of your stack should be filled, because it will fill everything up. And because this spacer is between the simple view and the hello.ui label 2, it is filling everything up between those two. Now, if we would move this down a little bit, so let's have this command alt and square braces, and make sure that you are on the line that you want to move, just move it down there and hit command R. You will see that the label will be pushed to the left of our view till it hits the spacing of 20, and it hits this view, the simple view, and of course this first one is the divider. So yeah, that is the point of a spacer. It fills up. And yeah, one use case is that, let's say you have a cell here and you have a profile image view, and you have the name and some description. Now, if you are using fill on the stack, it will fill all of the stack. But if you just push it up with a spacer, then it will push everything up like it should be, and maybe just add a divider on the top, so it might push down a little bit the text. But the spacer is used in this very own example. Now, you can see that in the vertical stack here, we have a divider, a label, a container, and a spacer. Now, all of this is basically pushing those three up to the top of our stack. Let's just comment out for a brief moment and see how this would look like. Well, not quite as pleasing as you would like. You will see that the last element is stretched throughout the whole container, because yeah, we have the distribution of fill. So yeah, just so you know, this is how you can use spacer and divider. Now, that is it for this tutorial. Please go ahead and take a look at the divider and spacer, and you know, they are quite humble, but they have a huge superpower in laying out your views, of course, inside the stacks. I hope you enjoyed this video. If you did, go ahead and give it a thumbs up, subscribe to the channel, and hit that notification bell to get notified of new videos, because in the next video we are going to talk about padding. Because yeah, why not? We can have dividers, but paddings are much more awesome. So yeah, go ahead and take a look at DuckUI. It is on my GitHub repository. And as usual, I will see you in the next one.